Good afternoon and a very warm welcome to Trinity Cathedral on this last day of November. Amazing, and it certainly feels kind of like it, doesn't it? Has that authentic Cleveland atmosphere today, you know? So we are delighted that you're here, and we look forward to the next few minutes of music featuring our Aeolian Skinner / Muller organ here in the chancel and our beautiful Flintrop organ in the back behind you. So we'll start and end up in the front. It'll be self-evident, and then I'm going to play a couple of lighter pieces on the Flintrop in the back. But I'm joined for this program by two of my friends and students at the Cleveland Institute of Music in the persons of Sol Rosato and Daniel Culliner. And they are each fabulous organists. And let me just think if there's any. A lot of this you'll recognize, obviously, the tunes here that these pieces are based on. And to just give you a little background on the composers, the first piece is by, as you might guess, a German composer, Siegfried Karg Ehlert, who lived in the latter decades of the 19th century and the first decades of the 20th century. From all that we know, he was not actually a very good organist himself, but he was a wonderful composer. He wrote some really fabulous stuff. And this sort of a fantasy on the old medieval tune in Dulce Jubilo has everything in it but the kitchen sink, all in about 6 minutes. So it's really fun to play. Soft stuff, loud stuff, fast, slow, everything. And it makes very good sense. So it's really a wonderful piece. Richard Purvis was for a long time the organist and director of music at Grace Cathedral in San Francisco, that beautiful building on Knob Hill that I'm sure many of you have at least walked by, if not been in. And his prelude on Green Sleeves, or What Child Is This, that beautiful old English melody, shows off some of the more beautiful soft colors of the organ. Then Sol is going to play a piece by Keith Chapman based on Bring a Torch, Jeanette Isabella. It's a really extroverted, fun piece. Keith was the organist of the Wanamaker store in Philadelphia and super talented guy who died far too young. He was a private pilot and had his own plane, and he was flying back from the West Coast and crashed near Pike's Peak in the Rockies. You know, it was one of those. So if you fly your own plane, be careful when you're going over the Rockies. And then Gerald Neer is another American composer, and this is a piece based on a Ukrainian carol. We, as you well know, think so much of our many friends in the Ukraine, and this is their bum ba ba bum bum ba ba bum, that famous melody, very skillfully treated in this case. So maybe we'll leave it from there, and Daniel can tell you a little bit about the piece he's going to play when the time comes. But in the meanwhile, next week, this same time, we have always one of my absolute favorite things of the year, our annual performance of The Ceremony of Carols by Benjamin Britten with the sopranos and altos of the Cathedral Choir and Jody Gwynn, harpist, one of the gorgeous pieces ever written by anybody, and it's always a privilege and a joy to be able to perform it. So that's next week, right here at noon on Wednesday, and then 2 weeks from today, we have our Messiah Sing for the first time since 2019, and I'm so looking forward to the return of that occasion. So we hope you'll be here for those things and other events as well, all of which are listed on the back of your program. I want to give a special plug for this coming Sunday, December 4th at 4 p.m. We have a service of lessons and carols for Advent that is a fairly new thing for us here at Trinity. It's a very beautiful service. So if that is of interest, we hope you might care to join us. And likewise, of course, for Christmas Eve. And we're going to have the Boar's Head back for, again, the first time since 2019 on New Year's Eve day, Saturday the 31st of December at 2 o'clock. One performance only. It's sort of a slow start for the Boar's Head, and we'll see how this goes the first time since in 3 years. But Saturday, the 31st of December at 2. So those are things to hopefully tantalize you and lure you back here often in the next few weeks. Lastly, we thank you in advance for your support. There's a basket there on the table. Anything that you can put in that basket, we're deeply grateful for. It helps so much in making this series possible, not only today's concert, but future concerts as well. And any of you watching online can likewise contribute by following the prompts at the bottom of your screen. You can do that through PayPal, or you can simply send a check made out to Music and Art at Trinity Cathedral. Mail it to Trinity Cathedral at 2230 Euclid Avenue, Cleveland, Ohio, 44115. So any way that you can help and support this series, we're very grateful. And that's enough talk from me, so music.
Thank you. So I feel that this next piece needs a little bit of introduction because not all of you might be familiar with Jonathan Scott. He is a prolific organist, improviser, arranger, transcriptionist, and living composer from Manchester in the United Kingdom. And he has concertized in England, in Germany, France, all over Europe and Asia. Yet in the midst of his hectic schedule, he found the time to compose this wonderful little Christmas fantasy, which features familiar Christmas carols and tunes you'll certainly be familiar with by the end. So I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
have had a long tradition of writing variations for the organ on well-known Christmas carols. And you just heard an example played on the Flintrop organ from Louis-Claude Daquin, who was one of the group of composers who lived in the latter 1700s, who were sort of known as Noelists because they all wrote these Noels, these variations on Christmas carols, and published books of them, and they're delightful pieces. That tradition continued on through well into the 20th century, well into the 21st century. And you heard Daniel's piece is sort of an English version of that same idea. And the great French organist Marcel Dupré tried his hand at that same thing in his variations on a Noël. A Noël is a French word for Christmas carol, basically. And he wrote this piece while he was traveling across the United States. And he made several big tours of this large country of ours. And in each case, he would start on the East Coast and play in New York and Boston and Philadelphia. And gradually, of course, it was in the days of train travel. This is the early 1920s. Slowly make his way across the country, ride the train, get off, play his concert in the next city, ride the train overnight, get off, practice, play his concert, ride the train. So he was much influenced by the American organs that he found, and he really enjoyed playing them. They were a lot different than the organs he'd grown up with in France. And so he wrote this series of variations to sort of show off some of the colors of these instruments. And he told in his memoirs how his routine for writing this piece would be after he would play his recital. As they say, he would get back on the train, probably have a drink or so, sit down, write another variation. Next night, same thing. So there's I'm playing about half the variations here. This is a slightly condensed version, but some of the ones that I think are really fun and really colorful and challenging to play. So Marcel Dupré's variations on a Noël.